well, not global anymore, but that Aura is a big team fight monster. Will it be enough for Flashpoint to take it? We jump into game one, Kaisu versus Flashpoint.
Thanks, Tom. Thanks, Tolly. And we absolutely are jumping in already, right in the middle of the action.
Back to the solo lane of Season 2, it was the exact same way. They're alone all the time. Why not try and get them ahead?
Mystify already low. Dracomarino's been pulled back in, and it's Shekio with Defender of Olympus for first blood. Dracomarino gets the Scarab's Blessing off, so Johnny ends up falling as well. Orchi claims his life. That's two for Kaisu already to get things started.
That, can you imagine them non-traditional compositions?
Flashpoint posturings if they want to try and fight over mid Harvest, but it's Worst Turtle who wants the action. What a CC chain taunt into Root, into Abduct. That's easy for Shekio to take down Fusify. Ferrocrick dips with that portal, does not want to be here any longer. And just like that, feels like it goes on forever. And your options are so limited, man, in terms of how you can get out of there. And Fusify is about to learn yet again. Pulled in right into the pin from Worst Turtle, the Erlong Shen running the early game.
Point. And so he is. Draco is unkillable by Johnny. Johnny just can't kill him.
Worst Turtle, the one to aggressive on this time, responds with a two-man ult of his own and a Scarab's Blessing so he can keep going aggressive. Fusify melts under the pressure. It's too much. And who else is here but Orchi? He rotates in with his ultimate of his own. They don't quite have anyone to lock down now, but not much chance of that working. Narrowly avoids getting rooted. But Worst Turtle, he might have committed a little bit too much to this. There's a lot of backup coming, and Worst Turtle ends up falling to Fusify. Johnny makes it out.
That's huge. And Kasmanify is going to get a tier 1 tower because Worst Turtle was on the way towards the left side to defend.
With all these slows coming out from Flashpoint, they got the Frostbound and the Gem of Isolation. Going to be hard to run from that. As Fusify is yet again the early target, Worst Turtle gets the kill, and that's Ferrocrick's ultimate already down just for damage. Johnny's in the thick of it, though, looking for a little bit more damage. And look how he's out trading Shekio. It's so much damage, but Julio puts a stop to it, steps on his neck, and Shekio gets credit.
Orchi gonna use that ultimate, just trying to slow everybody down, try and catch Ferrocrick, but it's not Orchi who will catch him. Well, cancel that, it is a nice two through the wall.
Yeah, y'all haven't had to fight the Zhongqui just yet, have you? And now Julio's making his presence felt. 0-0 and 2.
But it really needs to be Stone Cutting Sword, I think.
Rick Marino does a nice job getting Johnny's speeds in the mid lane. That last fight, Johnny, because of that, has no way out. Worst Turtle, he grabs a nice kill pretty easily, and a two-man taunt from Shekio. That pulls them right back into the waiting arms of Worst Turtle. Surrender vote coming out. His frustration starts to mount now for Flashpoint. Team Kaisu have proven to be a little bit too much, and onto the Fire Giant they go. It's just Kasmanify and Mogao who are nearby to try and slow down this objective grab, but they're dropping it. They want the fight instead. They go right for Kasmanify and force him out.
Just barely able to get away. Worst Turtle getting a little bit low, and he actually gets knocked into the fire pit. He's gonna be taking a lot of damage.
Yeah, he is in some trouble, but Mogao couldn't find the kill initially. Gets him on the back end, but all he does is take down Worst Turtle. He can't stop the Fire Giant from being claimed by Kaisu, but Julio has it. He can tell exactly where Mogao is, so they should be able to hunt him down without the ult.
We've seen Chernobyl get picked into the Jormungandr quite a bit. I believe that's Cyclone Spin who really likes that matchup. Stoppable. So, build it. Build it. Yeah, I don't know.
Most of Team Kaisu are in the left lane. Meanwhile, Worst Turtle is doing his best to battle against Johnny. And the three-level advantage does him well. Taunted back in, and Shekio gets his fourth kill of the game to put him a part of 11 of the kills that Kaisu finds. Another nice taunt. That brings in Ferrocrick and Kasmanify. And way into the back lane goes Worchi towards Mogao in the fountain. That does mean, though, that he has the angle to help cut off Kasmanify, and they grab the kill because of it. All right. Galaxy
like
Brain.
Yeah, that was pretty smart. That was intelligent by Worchi for sure. Fusify walks in, gets plucked right away by Dracomarino, and is insta-dead. Have you heard that one before?
I figured I'd let you have that since I did the other six Fusify deaths.
That's very fair. Yeah, thank you. Much appreciated.
No problem. There's enough for it to go around. Left side, Phoenix has now melted to the ground. Team Kaisu up.
It's the Hunbat's ult. That's where you want the Magi. Not against a team that has tons of CC like this.
Johnny's beads are on cooldown yet again, so Worst Turtle hunts him down with the taunt. Ferrocrick's ultimate goes whizzing past Worst Turtle's head, and that's yet another kill into Johnny. The set has not worked so far here in this game. Worchi's low, so he's gonna hang to the back, but underneath the actual Phoenix, there are some knockouts coming up from Lamoga, but the rest of Team Kaisu happy to dive. Julio finds Kasmanify, but the mid-Phoenix still healthy. It's been all about the fight so far, and Mogao can't quite handle it.
Worchi's still very low, but should be able to get some extra regen. No, actually doesn't have, oh, he does have the Blood Forge, so a little bit of lifesteal. I don't think it's going to matter too much, Finch. They should be able to just walk in.
It looks like they should. A dominant game number one here from Team Queso. Flashpoint doing their best to try and hold on, though it looks like Team Queso moved a little bit outside the room to look for a kill. Ferrocrick has found Worst Turtle, but once they turn their attention back to the Titan, this one's over and done with. Queso, nab game one.
Impressive stuff from Queso.
Make use of what he does, set the character being. So we'll see that happen. Chunga into two, as you know.
If you're Flashpoint, you're at least getting to play the game this time, which at this point last game, I don't know that they did. Chekio's really committed, and Johnny might be able to punish it for it. Fusify is on his way to this too. Hard to imagine Chekio could ever make it out of this. That's first blood for Johnny on the set. As I said, looking much better here in game two.
I think either of those are likely options. We could, I suppose, see a Warlocks, but I doubt it.
Fusify does a good job getting away from Draco Marino's ultimate there, and that sets up for Johnny to get his second kill of the game. Warchi goes up, but he does have to land near an enemy as Worst Turtle is able to find one kill onto Fusify, but now he's in some trouble as Johnny considers the dive. Meanwhile, Warchi, who ran all the way over to the shore over here when you normally don't have to in this meta, still feels pretty good for Queso, though, of course.
Doesn't feel good for Fusify. Hey, Finch, is Erlong Shen good? He CCs you longer than any other character in the game.
Ferrocrick in trouble here in the middle lane, does drop the supernova, but it doesn't help. Warchi cleans that kill up quite well. Is well then and can't get away very well.
Incorrect.
Okay.
Huh.
Well, he can't heal though, right?
He sure can.
Well, now Gold Fury being considered by Team Queso. They have to drop it as Kispanify jumps in. Warchi has to go up to the sky in the back, but it's Worst Turtle who needs a little bit of backup. Gets out of there with the turtle form, and Fusify dies to the right. Johnny, though, still wants blood. He finds Warchi looking for the second. It's Chekio, a double kill for Set, and still hunting for blood. He goes to the red buff to strip that too.
Now Johnny doesn't have to feel tense at all because he's 4-0. And take a look at the net worth. He's up 1,000 gold on Worst Turtle so far.
Having a good game. Oh, I didn't mention Worst Turtle on Erlong Shin has haste, by the way.
Yeah.
How did we not say that?
Only character in the game that has that in the game.
I mean it when I say has to. Set has just that kind of kill potential, but now maybe it's turnaround potential because Fanify has his own ultimate. Recall Demons is going to put out some work that lets them turn around onto Chekio, and they're still plenty healthy for another. Johnny gets a double kill onto Warchi. The knockup comes through from Ferrocrick as well, and now Worst Turtle is in a spot of bother. Fusify gets that kill, three members down, and Flashpoint looking much better here in this game.
Draco's in trouble. I don't think Johnny can afford to tank that summit because that the three Julio's own heal ends up anti-healing.
Fusify goes to the back line. They want the Worst Turtle, and they want him quickly. And Kispanify gets the job done. The Erlong Shen removed. Chekio, the next one in trouble. That's not the way you want to be using Eagle's Rally, but he didn't have much choice. Repositions underneath the tier two, but it's yet another red buff invade for Flashpoint, and they can take the fight here too. Warchi is moving so slowly, has no way out. He hides inside the wall, but they can continue to dive right underneath the tier two. Julio in trouble. That's how he joins the fight, is by taking an early spill. He's not alone though. Draco Marino falls as well. Next up is Warchi, as Johnny finds himself a double, and this is just a full-on DSI. Chekio has nowhere to go. Triple kill for Johnny. And this one might already be done, Ryan.
Out the ultimate, sometimes you can get out traded. Mogao has not really run into that problem too much so far.
He's been okay for the most part as Fusify drops the ultimate onto Julio, but does get hit by the Cataclysm. That's two man, so Worst Turtle is able to find Fusify. Team Queso now considering the disengage as Johnny has shown up, and he will gobble Julio up if they allow him. Limogao adds some extra damage, and that's enough for Julio to go down. It's 1-for-1. And now Team Queso have got to flee, get any way towards the tier 2 tower that they can, but the knockups from Ferrocrick cut the fight in half. Warchi tethered, Warchi gone. That's 2-1 in favor of Flashpoint.
And with this health build that Johnny's got, image, and you saw he didn't have any trouble killing Warchi now that he has Stone Cutting Sword, and the fact that he's 5 levels up, by the way, that health just makes him near unkillable.
Tier 2 tower drops, Chekio drops as well, nearly had Ferrocrick low enough for a kill, but it wasn't enough. Worst Turtle, I don't even know if he's going to make it to the heal. He does live just long enough for it, but still can't turn the fight around. Johnny gets another. We just want to run it down. This isn't about objectives. This is about finding some more kills. Worst Turtle pulled right back into the supernova from Ferrocrick. Waxing Moon, though, does hit 3. And that's about the best you can hope for from Chang'e. It just still does not deter Flashpoint. Warchi isolated and Johnny immortal.
Julio just used his immunity, and he's going to pay for it, no doubt about that. Johnny gets himself the double kill, a blood shield on top, which means he gets to keep on going.
Checkio now to trouble two, a triple kill for Johnny yet again. 13 kills for him, and a godlike performance from Johnny on this set. This is why he likes it, man. This is that hypercarry potential that he likes without Kwong and all these other types of assassins played by Caspanify and is every kind of dead I can think of.
Well, that's all of them, that's for sure. Johnny's in a bit of an awkward spot, though. No beads for him and half HP, but he teleports right out of that taunt.
And this is exactly the kind of fight that they want to take. Fusify goes in first, because Banify is there to follow, and he still can recall demons. Julio falls as well. Remember, they already lost Warchi earlier. That just leaves Draco and Checkio, the dual lane of old, to try and hold on and keep this game alive. But they might not even have Draco. Look how fast Johnny is. He chases him a football field length down this short lane and catches up to him. Right side, Phoenix down, and Aggro, I mean, that's just the game.
There's no chance for Kaiser to come back at this point. We're going to a game three, and I imagine that Queso will be a little bit more prepared for the set this time around.
Prepared for the set, and then also for the set
that Johnny's playing.
Not the set, but the set.
Panned out. Now it's in bets. We'll see how this non-set set goes.
Thanks for clearing everything up about that set there, Tom. I appreciate you. Into game number three, Finch and Aggro, one tier two tower and duo, having to try and shield himself from that pressure. Fusify, undeterred, even now, does get caught with the Cobra's Kiss. I mean, that's how that's going to go every time. A nice, clean kill.
That's always been my kind of philosophy, and I think that Queso is really identified with that as well.
Draco blinks in for Cataclysm, response is Fear No Evil, and now all of a sudden the Geb's been isolated. The impale's off the mark, but Draco still stands for now, but the bombs over the top are too much, and Fusify finds himself a kill. Worst turtle response, though, in kind. It's one for one in the middle lane. Last game, though, the Talaria boots might be a bit of a thing of the past. Like all these warrior tabi that have been picked up as Fusify gets caught in the middle lane, does get an Iron Turn's Blessing off, makes into turtle form, but will never see the heal.
We're finding this victory overall.
Stinger off the mark, worst turtle. Able to pass Spanify, but it still works out either way. A good bead uses Spanify. Johnny rotates in, and Fear No Evil sets up a nice, much needed kill in the war. So this time, though, it's Flashpoint playing around the objective with a nice gold three call. Worst turtle, though, pinned up against the wall underneath the tier one, and Johnny cleans up the kill with some help from Ferrocrick. That was all that it took.
Beautifully down there.
It's mostly pride when we're seeing from the Arthurian Pantheon. We'll talk about it later as Drake Arena gets two-man stun that catches Ferrocrick's dash. That's enough for the Ogden to go down. A much-needed kill here for Team Queso in the middle lane. Fusify now also a bit isolated from everyone else, but they don't have any more CC. He's just walking away.
Not yet, but it'll come eventually, and there it is. Warchi's able to get himself the kill. That was a weird dash in by Ferrocrick. I think he was trying to whip the camera around and dash away, but may have just pressed three a little bit too early and ended up sealing his own fate in that moment. You're asking about the Arthurian items.
Well, let's talk about this sick ultimate being found by Johnny here instead. Who wants to hear what Aggro has to say? But I'm to have the 45 or the 40 protections and the shield. It certainly doesn't hurt. Johnny, though, wants Fear No Evil and Warchi, but he gets caught by Worst Turtle, keeping Warchi alive there, truly doing the Lord's work. Flashpoint will instead consider a play here in the middle lane, but it's Julio who blinks in and catches out Ferrocrick. Checkio wants to keep things going over the wall with the Lawbringer, and Julio has the beast in his sights, but just can't get close enough. There it is, and Ferrocrick falls.
Yeah, but Julio is in a weird spot. I mean, just Checkio and Draco here to help him, but it looks like that's actually enough. I'm a little surprised that Flashpoint isn't willing to do a little bit more from that position. They know Warchi had to back, they know Wurfittle has no ultimate. They decide not to.
Once they end up dropping Ferrocrick, they felt like falling back, but Flashpoint don't want to give up this Primal Fury here for free. They don't have a ton of ultimates to work with, but they do still have plenty of damage, because Spanify is able to take down Warchi. Mogao's low, he's got to reposition, but Fusify, even without much mana or health, is moving forward, and he gets caught.
Now, Worst Turtle's going to find Johnny as well. Fusify cleaned up by Julio. Mogao caught lazy backing, and Worst Turtle might be able to make him pay, but Caspanify certainly will not.
Yeah, off the mark there with the Stinger. They really needed that one. He's forced to use the Aegis and might still die. Lawbringer back up again, because of course it is. Julio can't quite find Caspanify though, so he does not get punished.
Man, that really should have been a kill, even without Julio having to use the ultimate. Just a little bit too impatient on the power cleave that didn't outweigh the Aegis well enough.
Lord of the Afterlife does slow down Julio for a moment. The Tether should be able to find a stun, but Draco responds with a Cataclysm, and Julio gets a heal that forces Ferroquake to dash in aggressively, okay. But Julio does eventually still die to the passive there from the Agni, and now it's Mogao who's stuck too far forward without any mana.
And I mean, Aegis for Ferroquake might be enough to save his life, and it will.
Sloppy. Scary.
So you wanna keep them down while you can.
Primal has been looked at again. It's Queso that starts it. Worst Turtle has Caspanify on the menu. Throws him right back into every spear from Desert Fury. And Draco gets the kill credit. Fusify caught by Julio into the impale. Perfect from Queso. That's the cleanliness we were asking for last fight. All of a sudden, they're up 2-0 and ready to repull Primal.
And again, it's all centered around this CC that Queso has. They've got so much of it. I touched on it earlier on that if you don't have relics in those extended fights, means that you're going to use your relics sometimes late. You end up being really, really susceptible.
Julio catches Johnny. I bet it also helps if you can find two kills without ever having to worry about Fear No Evil, which is what Queso have done this fight. Ferroquake falls for three. They also get the Primal Fury. 3-0, and then your team plays really, really aggressive, really scrappy. The one that pays for it when it doesn't work is the one in that support role.
Exactly right. They're the ones who end up getting focused out very easily and have to go up against level, I don't know, 19 Chronosis.
Julio, though, aggressive in the backline yet again. He starts the fight. Draco Marino is the one stuck underneath the tier 2, but with that shield, he can take it. They now turn their attention to Fusify, who they end up pulling back towards the tier 1, but so far, it's much ado about nothing. Team Queso haven't been able to find a kill. In fact, Warchi a bit isolated. Lord of the Afterlife is there to lock him down with help from Ferroquake, but Julio had Fusify all to himself and gets a much-needed kill.
Good peel for Fikin
in these engagements, and it feels really strong for exactly what he's been doing, which is diving them both. As Draco locks down Caspanify into the Shockwave after the Cataclysm. Fear No Evil forced out, but Warchi's already gotten Lamogao. Tier 1 tower, that one's coming down as well. It's Fusify that gets the heal off, but he's gonna need a little bit more than that if they can find one more auto. Impale puts him against the tower too, but Fusify's still barely holding on.
Joe's so close, finally finished off by Worst Turtle. And now some more objectives should be following soon.
Yeah, this tier 2 tower should be all Team Queso here now. Flashpoint yet again forced out, and somehow they're coming out, it feels like. Just gets the rewind off, so he's right back into the thick of it. But Fusify's there waiting for him, so is Caspanify. But Worst Turtle and Warchi had different plans. They both go down quick.
Perfect job by Queso. Johnny does finally find Checkio, but it might cost him his whole team. He's already used the beads, already used the jump. Warchi just needs to find the autos.
Yeah, Johnny might have started turning away from this fight a little bit too soon, too. Might at least be able to get one more. But instead, he starts the retreat. Mogao should be safe underneath the tier 2, but it's hard to imagine a world where Johnny makes it out now.
Jumps up. Doesn't get knocked away. That's all I was going to say. Work. I was worried about that, but finally brought down. Warchi still looking for Mogao and
leashing it. They want the fight instead. Julio has Mogao controlled. As Fusify steps forward looking for a bit more, but way in the back line, Worst Turtle was trying to take down Ferroquake, and he did his job. Warchi comes in to clean up the actual kill credit. Caspanify low as well, and Julio is on a mission to hunt him down. That's another easy kill right into Fusify. Why not target swap? Aegis buys him a moment. That's Aegis on your support, by the way, and even still, he ends up falling. Add the tier 2 tower to the collect.
Ferroquake's also had a pretty rough one as well. I mean, game 1 on the Giannis didn't do a whole lot. Game 2 on the Soul did okay, but nothing that jumped off the page. And in game 3, he's really focused effectively.
We're working our way towards, you don't get lost without mistakes coming from a lot of places, so it certainly makes some sense as Flashpoint in a little bit more trouble. Johnny ends up dropping right side, Phoenix falling too, and there might even be some end potential. We're definitely ready for this fight.
I like Worst Turtle's split here. He's not as good at getting these Phoenixes as, say, a Hanbats or an Erlong Shen would be, but has the Magi, so he's free to 1v1.
An ambush over the wall means he's immediately ready to be in the fight. They go right for Ferroquake, way in the back line. And he is certainly dead to rights. At least tries to get off a bomb, but not much he can do. Fear No Evil comes out from Johnny. That slows down Queso for the moment and does set up for a nice kill to Julio, but left side Phoenix has been burned. That's exactly what Queso wanted, and now they can lock down Fusify, pull him in with the Copa's Kiss, but they still haven't gotten the kill. Warchi finally cleans it up.
Now should be Queso just going for the Titan. I mean, maybe you finish off this mid-Phoenix because it takes so little time for you, but it's time to end, fellas.
Certainly should be. They'll clean up this mini-wave. Right side Phoenix should die just to pressure from the fire minions, meaning all three Phoenixes are down. It's a 4v3 in favor of Team Queso, and there aren't any ultimates from Flashpoint to try and help out. Warjay leaps in place. That beats Johnny, and now they can move right to the Titan. It's already down, and Team Queso hold on to take down Flashpoint.
That's a big win for Team Queso, Finch. Yeah. First week of the SML.